Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name's David, and today I'm going to be installing the Renogy inverter charger, the 2000 watt model or the 3000 watt model. They have the same installation. The only thing that differs is possibly the cable size, but I'm going to show you exactly how I installed mine. A while back, I made a video reviewing this product and I got a lot of questions on how to install it. So that is what we are doing today. If you guys are interested, I've developed a simple solar guide that I will link below in the description. It covers everything from price and quantities to component overviews and also a wiring schematic, which is really useful. So if you're a beginner or you don't know much about solar components, this is the perfect guide for you. I will also link below all the products that I've used on my solar install for this inverter. If you want to check those out, head down into the description below and click on those. All right, let's get to the install. So first things first, this is a big heavy component. Besides the battery, this is gonna be your largest and heaviest component. I decided to mount mine right above my battery because it fit really well there, although I did have to support it. And I did that by mounting a 2x2 and then a 1x4, so a bit of a structural frame. I also screwed it to the plywood that I have along the back of my van. So it is very secured on there. But yeah, keep that in mind when you're doing your layout. Really pay attention to the weight factor and also ventilation. When you're maxing out these inverters, whether it's 2000 watts or 3000 watts, I have a water heater that gets up to about 1800 watts of draw. So I'm almost maxing out my inverter and you can hear that fan kicking on. So you wanna make sure it's in a well ventilated spot and you don't wanna cover it up too much. As you can see, I've mounted mine, yeah, right above my battery. And then I have a 1x4 that goes right from the roof all the way into the floor, which I've screwed on both sides, and then also a 2x2 going back to support it. And then I've also screwed two screws in the top here, and then on that side underneath as well, there's two brackets down there. All right, so we are gonna start with the 12 volt battery connections. So you can see right here, I have my positive battery wire going in here. I know it's black, it's a little confusing, but that was the only thing that I could find. I couldn't find red, unfortunately. So this comes out, goes directly to a 200 amp fuse, an ANL fuse, and then it goes down and connects to my positive bus bar. My negative battery connection comes out and goes to my negative bus bar. These cables are 2-aught cables, both of them. For 2000 watt inverter, you want to use the 2-aught cable. For the 3000 watt, you're going to want to use the 4-aught battery cable. So those are going to be big cables. They're hard to work with. So try to make your runs as short as possible. This is the 120 volt inlet and outlet. This comes right in from the shore power. And this is 10 gauge, 3-conductor wire. This is 12 gauge. I would recommend that you use marine wire on both of these, on all the wire inside the camper van. Actually, I would recommend using a marine grade wire. They withstand temperature change better. They're more flexible, more hardy. And I didn't use them because I couldn't get my hands on any during like COVID and everything that was going on. There were shortages and I wasn't able to order any in. So I just went with, this is just normal household 120 volt wire and it's worked just fine, but I would recommend using marine grade stuff if you can. This small wire I have going out is just to the remote on off switch. So that basically just feeds up and then over, and it's located inside underneath my bench so I don't have to come around the back here to turn it on and off. The 120 volt input comes in right here and I've snaked it up. So the 30 amp disconnect is just a bit of a safety feature just in case I plug into somewhere that's a little bit sketchy. I don't know what kind of power is coming in, if it's grounded properly. So this is kind of just in case I plug into somewhere that's bad, it doesn't wreck my inverter charger. So yeah, just a little bit of protection there. I know that this has a built-in fuse and protection system basically, but I wanted to do this kind of just as a backup. It's a cheap kind of feature that I think is a good idea to install, and I would recommend that you install as well. So the wire goes basically into the disconnect and then out, and then it goes around, and the wire actually comes right out here. So this is my 30 amp inlet right there. I usually don't plug into a 30 amp system. I'm usually to a 15 amp system, which is why I have this guy right here. But I really like this. I got off Amazon, and I'll put the link in the description below, but there's a light on top to see if you have power. You can see that I have power right now. And then this handle is also really nice. And then the fact that it just 90s straight down, so it's not jetting too far out of the side of the van. That is my shore power connection point. And then we can go back inside the van. You can actually hear that my inverter fan just kicked on there. That is the 120 volt inlet. And then what I've done for my outlet is this 12 gauge wire basically runs up and connects to this guy right here, which is a small breaker box designed for up to four breakers essentially. So basically I have one breaker that is wiring my 120 volt outlets. And then I have one breaker that's specifically installed for my hot water tank. Again, I know that the 30 amp disconnect and the breaker box is overkill because the inverter does have internal protection, but I wanted to install those things just for a little added cheap protection. It's a lot easier to flip a breaker or replace a fuse than it is to have to replace this inverter possibly, or go inside and replace internal fuses. I would recommend that you do the same. They're really easy to install. I know as long as you ground them properly, run the positives and run the negative, it's pretty easy to do. If you don't know how to do that, I would recommend watching some YouTube videos on just basic electrical. All of these wiring components come with schematic diagrams that are really easy to follow, including the 30 amp connection point on the outside, the 30 amp fuse disconnect, and then the breaker box. So it's really basic to install and easy for anyone to do. The fuse and the breakers also protect the wiring, which is key because I don't want to be feeding new wires through the van. It would be a pain in the butt. It would be doable, but a pain in the butt that I'd like to avoid. If this video was confusing or there are things that you don't understand, I would recommend you buy the solar guide. I'll link it up here and then also in the description below. The guide really helps you go through, and you can take your time and really absorb a lot of the information. So I know this component can be a little bit tricky to install. It's easier to think about it if you break it down into two systems completely. You have a 12 volt and 120 volt side, and the wiring is different, the fusing is different. Like, you need to use 120 volt breakers instead of fuses. I've seen people install 12 volt fuses in place for 120 volts. And you don't want to do that. That's not the way it's done. You need to use proper breakers and proper fuses. As far as programming the inverter charger, it is basic to do. This inverter charger works with lithium, gel, lead acid. Basically, you select which battery you want to use, and then it will automatically adjust all the settings to work with a lithium battery or a lead acid battery. So that is simple and easy. As far as adjusting the amperage for shore power, I have set mine to only pulling 15 amps because I usually plug into houses or other places that only have a 15 amp outlet. A lot of campgrounds have a 30 amp outlet, but I just don't need that much amperage when I'm plugged in because we only have the two outlets. And even with the hot water tank, we've never blown a breaker or a fuse. So if you want to pull 30 amps, it's really easy to adjust. One thing that I would recommend you do, instead of having a 12 volt fuse panel and a breaker box like I have, you can actually order a distribution panel which has both of those things in one component. So that cuts down a lot of space. I didn't do this during my install because last year they were unavailable. I couldn't order one in anywhere, so I decided to go with just the breaker box and the 12 volt fuse panel. It's okay, it takes up a little more space. As you can see, I had to actually mount that breaker box.
underneath our bed, like on the roof. So that's not ideal, but again, I don't use it a lot. I don't touch it. And the breakers have never gone off. So that's okay. But the distribution panel, I will link in the comments below. If you wanna check that out, I would highly recommend it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful. If you liked it, be sure to like it, subscribe to the channel. There's lots more content on my channel regarding solar systems and our camper van build. So be sure to check those out. And I will see you in the next one.